The short answer is yes. We can even assign a parameter to change the quantity of concentric spherical shells. But there are going to be a few caveats, as we shall see later. My interest in attempting to create concentric spherical shells via a pattern was sparked by Normaker's video some time ago, as well as a more recent video by Product Design Online. In both of these videos, the workflow involved creating cross-sectional sketch profiles for revolving. Unfortunately, these cannot be patterned. This got me thinking about the possibility of formulating a workflow in which some sort of pattern can be used to create this design. I don't claim the following method to be a better method than what has been shown. Indeed, I expect that many of you would consider the caveats to be deal breakers. This is just an alternative for you to consider. This video can also serve as a good exercise on how to use parameters. When it comes to applying a pattern to produce a concentric effect, there is one major challenge. If we perform a linear pattern on an arc, the patterned arcs do not increase their radii as we progress along the pattern path. All these arcs have the same radii, and their center points move along the pattern path. Note that this is the case even if you pattern an offsetted arc. To achieve concentricity, we need the radii of the patterned arcs to increase. We also need them to share the same center point. To achieve this design with a pattern, we need to break it down into two stages of revolves. If we just look at a single spherical shell, we can achieve this by revolving a straight line into a surface, and then performing a solid revolve using this surface. So the pattern that we need to do here is actually a series of straight lines. Begin a sketch on the front plane. Let's start with a horizontal line which will define the thickness of our innermost spherical shell. With the dimension field active, we can assign a parameter on the fly by entering a name for the parameter, followed by an equal, and followed by the value. Click on the horizontal vertical constraint and align this endpoint horizontally with the origin. Next, we shall define the distance between the endpoint of the line and the origin. Again, we can set this on the fly by entering a name for the parameter and the value. This dimension will define the radius of the inner spherical void. If we open the parameters dialog, we see both parameters in our favorites list. At this point, let's add a parameter for the gap between the shells. This will not be something that can be conveniently added on the fly, so this is why I'm adding it here. Click on the plus sign next to User Parameters. Name the parameter. Set the units and value. Let's favorite this parameter. Begin a rectangular pattern. Select the line as the object. Set distance type to spacing. We will use the default horizontal direction. For the quantity field, we can assign a parameter on a fly just like we did when dimensioning the sketch. After finishing typing this expression, do refrain from hitting the Enter key, as that would end the rectangular pattern command. Go to the distance field. The spacing is defined by the length of the line plus the gap that we need between the lines. We can type in the expression, thickness plus gap. Notice that as you type in the word thickness, a pop-up appears, letting you know that there is an existing parameter named thickness. You can click on that and carry on with the expression. Let's confirm. Let's set a driven dimension to check on the spacing. We can go back into the rectangular pattern command by double-clicking on this icon. You can see that the formula in the spacing distance field is still saved. If we open the parameters dialog, we can see the newly assigned quantity parameter. If we increase this quantity, the pattern would adjust accordingly. Confirm the sketch. Activate the Surface tab. Go to Create, Revolve. Box select all sketch lines. For axis, click on the Select box. Theoretically, it should be possible to revolve this about the Y-axis or the Z-axis. But for some reason, Fusion would only allow us to select the Y-axis in this case. Revolve this for an angle of 180 degrees. Next, activate the Solid tab. Go to Create, Revolve. Box select all these profiles. For axis, select the X-axis. We shall perform a full revolve. After revolving, the surface bodies still exist, as you can tell by this H. Expand the Bodies folder. Control select all the surface bodies. Right-click and hide them. Let's create a cross-section to take a look at the spherical shells. To create a final shape, we can perform an intersect. Let's perform a sketch on the top plane. Sketch a center point rectangle centered on the origin. First, let's make both sides equal. The square has to fully cover the sphere. We can choose to make the square tangent to the sphere, but I would advise against doing that. When we make changes to the quantity parameter, this reference will most likely be lost. Let's dimension one of the edges and set a parameter on the fly. Give it an arbitrary value for the moment. Let's open the Parameters dialog. Locate the square parameter. We want the size of the square to adjust according to the size of the outermost spherical shell. So it will make sense to formulate an expression based on the thickness of the spherical shells and the gap between the shells. Enter the formula as follows. This portion of the expression is basically a multiple of the thickness and the gap, the value of which is added to the inner radius. This resulting value is then multiplied by 2. If we hide all the bodies and bring back the first sketch, we can see that this formula also adds a gap between the square and the outermost line. Whenever you adjust a quantity, this gap will be maintained. Use this sketch to perform an extrude. Set direction to symmetric. Set the operation to intersect. The command calculates the intersecting volume between the extrude and the existing bodies and removes everything else. Let's talk about the caveats. If we go into the Parameters dialog and increase the quantity, notice that the design does not update. The only entities that update properly are the sketches. This is because the revolve and the extrude commands are not able to pick up on the newly formed entities. To resolve this, we will need to go into each feature and add the new entities accordingly. First, go into the surface revolve and add this edge. Next, go into the solid revolve and add this surface. Finally, go into the last extrude feature. Go to Objects to Cut and select the new body. If you try to decrease the quantity, the features also do not update properly. In this case, I found that you can resolve them by simply opening up the features and closing them without changing anything. So it might be a good idea to start a design with more shells than you need and modify from there. Personally, I find that this method greatly simplifies the sketch and offers a viable way of changing the quantity without the need to edit the base sketch. Although there's a need to manually manage the new references with the change in quantity, I think those edits are quite manageable.